it was my first work without teacher, you know. And the piano variations, that's a kind of amalgam of what I knew before and what I want to be. It's a very important work for me, for technical point of view. You know, it's a mix of surreal, of modern music, even tonal and chromatic, all this thing. And after the piano variations in 64, it was very quiet until Glenn Gould, who put in record. Like Glenn Gould. You know, for my career, it was really the beginning. And the week after that, I know that Glenn Gould, I had commissions, 3 or 4 commissions.
Jacques Hetu spent 2 years in France. When he came back, he began teaching at Laval University, where he stayed for the next 15 years. He consolidated the distinctive style that had first come out in his piano variations. It was a style with a broad appeal to instrumental soloists, and he received a stream of commissions for concertos. By the time Robert Cram commissioned a flute concerto in 1991, he had a pretty good idea of what he could expect from Hetu.
The people that I admire in this world are the ones who, when you hear the music, even if they're speaking a slightly different language for one reason or another, because of the genre that they're using, because they're attempting something new, you recognize a voice instantly. And Jacques has a voice. When you hear a few chords of his, you just simply know Jacques Hetu wrote that piece of music. I knew that there would be a lyricism because he's unabashedly lyrical. In fact, the first impression one gets on meeting him is that he is a man who's very comfortable in his skin as a person and as a composer. He knows what he's going to be writing. He has a language of his own and he loves it.
Hetu's devised a complex language of his own, but if there's one reason musicians like Robert Cram can identify his work within a few chords, it's his harmony.
My melodies are very often inside the 12 tones, but the harmony came from modal scales, you know.
Put a G major chord.
No, it's not so tonal that what I play, but it gives you an idea of very simple chords and a very chromatic melodic line. Kind of. So, you know, I mixed model scales with tonal effects, with chromatic melodies.
Mario Bernardi has conducted the premieres of half a dozen works by Jacques Hetu. He learned long ago what to expect from the composer.
Something well-crafted, something that has unmistakably got a French flavor to it. It seems that he has that. That's a sort of a given. To my ears at least, you know, everything that he writes seems to sort of echo things of the past from France. I mean, this doesn't sound like Debussy, but one sees a little bit of an accent there that recalls him and Roussel too, perhaps. But it goes further than that, of course. I don't mean to say that he is not original. He is original. I also expect from him a piece that will work very well.
Oh, well, you go to Jacques Hetu for something that works.
Arthur Kaptainis has written about 60 performances of Hetu's work during his 15 years as music critic for the Montreal Gazette.
I don't want to sound cynical about this, but it's vital for an orchestra or a commissioning body to feel safe. Now, that's a dangerous word, I'm quite aware of that, but there are enough composers out there with whom you feel unsafe to approach a composer who will inevitably produce something that is of high professional caliber is a natural thing for orchestras to do. You know, that means that there will be at least one curtain call after the premiere. That means there will be time for the composer to march down the stairs and get up on the stage and take a bow. If I sound like I'm being a little cold-hearted about that, think about what the opposite situation is. I mean, it's pretty dreadful. So they go to Jacques Hetu for something that works. But I think they can honestly go to Jacques Hetu also for something that will last. I mean, something that has meaning, that sounds like it was worth commissioning in the first place.
Implicit in Kaptainis' reaction to Jacques Hetu's music is a critical paradox. One has to admit the success of a work that's crafted by a master and that connects with an audience on first hearing. On the other hand, there's a whiff of critical suspicion. New music has to be difficult and challenging to be meaningful. To be really good, it has to ignore familiar landmarks and stretch the envelope. The critical establishment, especially in Quebec, has always struggled with what to make of Hetu's music. When Hetu was coming of age in the 60s and 70s, the new music scene in Quebec was dominated by the Société de musique contemporaine du Québec. Its avant-garde aesthetic precluded serious critical consideration of a composer who's so proudly traditional.
I am a romantic, you know. So what it means that about my structures and my melodic way, I think that I am really from the German and Viennese music. About the sounds, I am very French. About the orchestral, about the the sonorities, that. So it's a mix of, it's normal, I think, mix of German and French.